When browsing for server CPUs, I often see processors that are well under market value, sometimes a quarter or a third of the price of other similar processors on the market. These processors are branded as engineering samples, qualifying samples, or Intel Confidential. Today I'm going to take a look at some of these Intel engineering sample processors, compare them to the same processor in its normal value, find out what the differences are, and go over if it makes sense trying to get a engineering sample for your use case to try to save some money, or you should just get the real processor. I want to note for this video, these are going to be my experiences with a specific set of engineering sample processors on a specific board with the test I've ran. This is not going to be representative of every possible engineering sample processor in every possible configuration. I also want to say a big thank you to Unix Surplus for providing this hardware used in this video. They're a great place to find used server hardware and have many different CPUs, servers, and other options to pick from. Let's take a look at the physical processors first. Physically, these processors are the same. The only differences between the engineering sample I had and the standard Xeon 6148 processor that I had was the markings on the chip. Intel likely has some sort of internal markings they don't want to tell us about. That means like internal bins and samples and all that sort of things during manufacturing, but other than those labels, they're the same processor. The Intel Confidential chips are kind of a pain to know what they are sometimes because they don't say what they normally would be if they weren't an Intel Confidential chip like the normal Xeons do. You can actually Google the little code on it, and it does bring up a Xeon 6148 that I had in my example, but it did require a little bit more Googling and looking at to find out what exactly was going on. Now let's take a look at performance and compatibility. For all of my testing today, I use Intel S2600BP boards. This board is designed for a 2U4 node enclosure, so it's a weird skinny form factor. But other than its different shape, this is identical to almost every other LJ3647 board. We have two processors on board, 8 memory slots per processor, and a couple of PCIe slots and onboard networking for connectivity. When I put the different processors in each of the boards, they worked all identically. Doing things like BIOS configuration, booting into an OS, installing programs, putting cards in, working with different storage drives, all worked the same between the engineering sample processors and the standard Xeon 6148 that I had. There was no noticeable difference or weird oddities or anything like that. And even booting into an operating system, the processor just showed itself as a Xeon 6148 for even the engineering sample processor. If I want to find out that it was an engineering sample processor in the OS, I had to use CPU-Z or similar tools and would have a :ES at the end of the model number, whereas the normal one didn't. All the other information on CPU-Z was the same, things like stepping information and other things. I'm not sure exactly what Intel is doing internally, but it looks like these are pretty darn similar chips from all the information I can see, and things like the internal bin number makes it think that my engineering sample is really a pretty close to retail chip. Next, I want to take a look at performance between these two different processors. I ran a different variety of tests to test the different parts of a processor, and there was no significant difference. I ran many different tests, multiple different times, just to try to see if I could work out some little edge case or something that it would have a difference in. I can't try every possible use case, but I'd say on average it was basically identical, and I couldn't find any significant difference between the two processors. But I did have this gut, maybe there's something different and it doesn't do some instructions right. Modern processors like these have a huge list of different possible instructions that they can compute, so you want to make sure that they can actually do them all. Intel has a nice little processor diagnostic toolkit that you can run, and it'll check all the instructions, like the AVX512s and all of these other new instructions they have. And both of these processors I've had just passed without any issue. So it doesn't look like there's any discernible issues or problems with running my engineering sample chips that I had. They seem to be essentially the same. And for my testing, I don't see any reason not to run these engineering sample chips. They performed the same, they had the same compatibility, they worked with all the different hardware that I had, and why not get the cheaper chip in that case? And this gets to the part of the video where it's a lot more about speculation and guessing and things like that on types of processors, and less of the hard data of the chips I had. Because I know engineering chips are a lot more of a gamble than retail chips are. Your boards like these are going to be guaranteed to work with all the retail chips that they say they're compatible with, but they're not officially compatible with any engineering sample chips because Intel doesn't want regular consumers like me or you to go out and buy these and work with these. So it's a lot more of a luck of the draw. I've heard many people online talking about engineering sample chips and what chips they have and what boards they want to work with. So that can be one great way to research and try to figure out if you can get an engineering sample chip to work with your specific board. Guessing and checking can work, but that's a lot of a hassle often, and means spending quite a bit of time finding different chips and boards and putting them together. And it often becomes, is the cost saving worth the extra hassle you have to deal with? I'd probably only do the hassle of engineering chips on fairly high-end processors. Like, these are 20-core chips, which are pretty competent today, but if I just needed a basic storage server with one of these systems and wanted to get, like, a cheap 8-core chip, I wouldn't do the gamble, just get the normal retail processor. Another way to make it so your engineering sample chips are much more likely to work is purchase the chips and the motherboards or a whole server with engineering chips. This means that someone else who's selling you those used chips and motherboards together can do testing, confirm they work, and give you a working combo. Typically, once you have a working motherboard and engineering sample chips with the motherboard, everything else can kind of be changed and worked with without any major issues, as they seem to have the same compatibility with things like PCI Express devices and storage, so once you have the working combo of motherboard and CPU, you're set. One interesting thing I've noticed is there seems to be quite a few of these chips, so I'm guessing a lot of them are pretty close to retail and might be just early samples for large cloud customers or something like that, but then again, it's hard to know. But with the significant price savings of these chips, I think it can be worth the gamble if you want a high-performance server chip and are willing to make a gamble and deal with some of the possible issues you can run into. Because these chips can easily get into the thousands of dollars per CPU, engineering sample chips will save you a lot of money. Let me know if you have experiences working with engineering chips in the comments below and how they've worked out for you. If you want to check out another video on CPU things, check out this one in Proxmox's P&E course. That's another kind of cool technology with processors that's made it to the market recently. Another thing is check out Unix Surplus again if you want to see other used server hardware, and they have all of these cool CPUs if you want to take a look or get some of them for yourself. Thanks for watching.